Hello and welcome to the Magic of Mathematics channel. My name is Manohar Murthy and you are watching one amongst a series of videos exploring the world of mathematics. In this video, I intend to explain how to perform addition and subtraction of integers on the number line. If you are interested in understanding the rules for performing addition and subtraction of integers on the number line in an intuitive way, then you will find this video useful. I assume here that you are familiar with integers and how to represent them on the number line. I also assume that you are familiar with addition and subtraction of natural numbers on the number line. I would like to mention here that I will use only simple cases involving a single addition or subtraction operator. However, the logic that I present in this video can be easily extended to deal with more complex arithmetic expressions. Now that we know what we will be dealing with in this video, let us get down to the task at hand. Before I go ahead with presenting the intuitive rules for performing addition and subtraction of integers on the number line, I would like to state here a well-known fact, namely that conceptually, positive and negative integers are opposites of each other. In other words, a negative integer is conceptually the opposite of the positive integer of the same magnitude. If you are not familiar with this concept, you should watch my video where I deal with the question, what are integers and why do we need them? With this background, we can go ahead and look at how we can intuitively perform addition and subtraction of integers on the number line. For this, let us draw a number line and mark 0 on the number line. As we know, we represent positive integers to the right of 0 and negative integers to the left of 0. We will make markings on the number line when we look at specific examples. But first, I'll present the rules for performing addition and subtraction of integers on the number line in a generic way. And for that, we don't need markings representing specific numbers. To present the intuitive rules for performing addition and subtraction of integers on the number line, I will perform a number line walk. Before I do this, I would like to mention that we are dealing with a lot of different cases here, as the operator could be the addition operator or the subtraction operator, and each of the operands involved could be a positive integer or a negative integer. To make the explanation of the rules simple, I will be using a specific case. Once the rules are clear in the context of one case, I will consider a few examples to show that the rules are general enough to work on all cases. Now we are ready for our number line walk. For starting the number line walk, I look at the first operand to determine the starting point. The starting point could be on the positive part of the number line or on the negative part of the number line, and is determined by the first operand. For now, let us look at the case where the first operand is a positive integer, which means that I will stand at a point on the positive part of the number line as shown. Next, I look at the operator. If it is an addition operator, I turn to walk towards the right as shown. And if it is a subtraction operator, I turn to walk towards the left. Notice here that I have used the well-known fact that subtraction is in a sense the opposite of addition. Again, for explaining the rules, let us look at the case where our operator is an addition operator, in which case I will be ready to walk towards the right side of the number line as shown. Now, I look at the second operand to determine how I walk. If the second operand is a positive integer, I will walk forwards by a number of unit steps equal to the magnitude of the operand. However, if the second operand is a negative integer, I will walk backwards by a number of unit steps equal to the magnitude of the operand. Again, this makes intuitive sense as negative integers are conceptually the opposite of positive integers. Now that we have looked at the rules for performing addition and subtraction of integers on the number line, let us apply the rules in the context of a few examples. The first example that I will take up is negative 3 plus negative 2. As before, I draw a number line, but this time with markings representing the positive and negative integers. In this example, the first operand is negative 3. So, I will start my journey from negative 3. Now, since we have the addition operator, I turn to walk towards the right. Next, I look at the second operand, which happens to be a negative integer of magnitude 2. This means I need to walk 2 steps backwards, thereby ending up at negative 5, which is what our expression evaluates to. The second example that I will take up is negative 3 minus negative 2. Here, the first operand is again negative 3. So, I stand at negative 3 again. However, the operator in this expression is the subtraction operator, and hence I turn to walk towards the left. Next, let us look at the second operand. This is negative 2, which means I need to walk 2 steps backwards, thereby ending up at negative 1, which is the result of evaluating the given expression. The third example that I will take up is negative 2 plus 2. Here, the first operand is negative 2, and hence I begin my journey from negative 2. The operator being the addition operator, I turn to walk towards the right. The second operand is 2, which means I walk 2 steps forward, thereby ending up at 0. And thus, the given expression evaluates to 0. The last example that I will take up is 2 minus 4. In this example, the first operand is 2, and hence I begin my journey from 2. Since the operator here is the subtraction operator, I turn to walk towards the left. The second operand is 4, which means I walk 4 steps forward, thereby ending up at negative 2. And hence, the given expression evaluates to negative 2. In this video, we looked at an intuitive way to perform addition and subtraction of integers on the number line. We also looked at 4 examples to illustrate the rules that I presented. I hope you found the video useful. Thanks for watching.